Welcome once again. Right now we're at Acts chapter 23, verses 12 to 35. The plot to murder Paul. When it was day, some of the Jews banded together and bound themselves under a curse, saying that they would neither eat nor drink until they had killed Paul. There were more than 40 people who had made this conspiracy. They came to the chief priests and the elders and said, "We have bound ourselves under a great curse to taste nothing until we have killed Paul. Now, therefore, you with the council inform the commanding officer that he should bring him down to you tomorrow, as though you were going to judge his case more exactly. We are ready to kill him before he comes near." That was their first mistake. They were a little bit too talkative about their plans. But Paul's sister's son heard they were lying in wait, and he came and entered into the barracks and told Paul. Paul summoned one of the centurions and said, "Bring this young man to the commanding officer, for he has something to tell him." So he took him and brought him to the commanding officer and said, "Paul, the prisoner, summoned me and asked me to bring this young man to you. He has something to tell you." The commanding officer took him by the hand and, going aside, asked him privately, "What is that you have to tell me?" He said, "The Jews have agreed to ask you to bring Paul down to the council tomorrow, as though intending to inquire somewhat more accurately concerning him. Therefore, don't yield to them, for more than 40 men lie in wait for him, who have bound themselves under a curse to neither eat nor drink until they have killed him. Now they are ready, looking for the promise from you." So the commanding officer let the young man go, charging him, "Tell no one that you have revealed these things to me." He called to himself two of the centurions and said, "Prepare 200 soldiers to go as far as Caesarea, with 70 horsemen and 200 men armed with spears, at the third hour of the night," that is about 9 p.m. He asked them to provide animals, that they might set Paul on one and bring him safely to Felix the governor. He wrote a letter like this: "Claudius Lysias, to the most excellent governor Felix, greetings. This man was seized by the Jews and was about to be killed by them when I came with the soldiers and rescued him, having learned that he was a Roman. Desiring to know the cause why they accused him, I brought him down to their council. I found him to be accused about the questions of their law," that is the Torah, "but not to be charged with anything worthy of death or of imprisonment. When I was told that the Jews lay in wait for the man, I sent him to you immediately, charging his accusers also to bring their accusations against him before you. Farewell." So the soldiers, carrying out their orders, took Paul and brought him by night to Antipatris. But on the next day they left the horsemen to go with him and returned to the barracks. When they came to Caesarea, they delivered the letter to the governor. They also presented Paul to him. When the governor had read it, he asked what province he was from. When he understood that he was from Cilicia, he said, "I will hear you fully when your accusers also arrive." He commanded that he be kept in Herod's palace. So in our next session, we are going to read about Paul's trial before Felix. Seek God while he may be found. If you seek him with all your heart, you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.